So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247. So I hope your NABARD grade A preparations are going well and aajkal kuch bhi mat karo, sirf focus karo NABARD examination pe because around 1 month is now left. So focus on whatever you have studied and abhi bhi time hai, kuch bhi aap naya padhna chahte ho to abhi bhi time hai to aap padh sakte ho, right? And this session, guys, is very helpful for your NABARD grade examination and all the other examinations as well, all right? And in today's session, we are going to talk about PIB news from 1st to 3rd August 2022. And in all, there will be 16 questions today, right? So let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you want to have the PDF of this session, you can join the Telegram channel. The link is provided in the description, right? And if you want to ace the NABARD examination this year, you can join the crash course for NABARD grade A by visiting anujindal.in, right? So let's talk about the very first question, which says, what is the total estimated cost of Nagar Van Yojana being implemented by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change? Now, first of all, who is the Minister of Environment, Forest and Climate Change? It is Mr. Bhupendra Yadav. Bhupendra Yadav is also the Minister of Labor and Employment, right? And this Nagar Van Yojana is nothing new. It is already being implemented by this ministry. It is in news because a reply has been submitted by the ministry in the parliament, right? So let's talk about this Yojana. Remember the objective of this Yojana. Basically, what government is doing under this scheme? So they are developing 400 Nagar Vans. Nagar Vans are nothing but urban forests. These are urban forests, right? And 200 Nagar Vatikas. And Nagar Vatikas are basically urban gardens. Right, so the objective of this scheme, guys, of this Yojana is to develop 400 urban forests and 200 urban gardens in the country, right? And it was launched in financial year 2021 with a period starting from financial year 2021 to up to financial year 2025. Now, please remember, it is not financial year 2026, right? Generally, in most of the schemes, jo ki aajkal hum padh rahe hain, usme जो पीरियड है, पीरियड ऑफ इंप्लीमेंटेशन है, दैट इज अप टू फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2026. बट इन दिस स्कीम, इन दिस योजना, इट इज अप टू फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2025. सो प्लीज डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज. एंड द टोटल आउटले फॉर दिस इज ₹895 करोड़. ऑलराइट, सो दिस मच इंफॉर्मेशन इज इनफ अबाउट दिस स्कीम. इससे ज्यादा करने की जरूरत नहीं है, दैट हाउ दे आर गोइंग टू प्लांट, हाउ दे आर गोइंग टू एस्टैब्लिश दिस दीज नगर वैन्स एंड ऑल, दैट इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड एट ऑल. ऑलराइट, so now let's come back to the question. So what is the total outlay? It's 895 crores. Option D is the correct answer for a period starting from financial year 21 up to financial year 2025, not 6. All right, moving ahead to question number 2. During his visit to India, president of Maldives Ibrahim Mohammed Soleh, he is the president, do you remember the name? Phase 1 mein pucha ja sakta hai, has signed various MOUs with India. Which of the following is an area for which MOU has not been signed? ठीक है, इनमें देखो बहुत सारे areas में MOU sign हुआ है during his visit, during Soli's visit to India. So you have to identify कि कौन से area में MOU sign नहीं हुआ है, right? So these are the area, guys, in which the MOUs have been signed between the two countries. Number one is fishing zone forecast capacity building, right? जो fishing zone है वहां पे forecast करने के लिए capacity building की जाएगी, number one. Number two, cyber security. For enhancing cyber security in both the countries, the MOU has been signed. Number three, capacity building of women development committees and government authorities of Maldives, right? Then there is an MOU on disaster management as well. Then there is an MOU on construction of police infrastructure. For that, $41 million ka buyer's credit agreement has been signed. And letter of intent for buyer's credit financing of ₹2000 social housing units, right? 2000 social housing units banane ke liye, this letter of intent has been signed between the two countries. So these are the areas for which the MOUs have been signed between these two countries, and therefore the correct answer will be what? The correct answer will be option B, school infrastructure, because that is an area for which any MOU has not been signed between these two countries during the recent visit of Ibrahim Mohammed Soli to India. All right, moving ahead to question number 3. What is the total outlay of Ayush Aushadhi Gunvatta Evam Utpadan Samvardhan Yojana being implemented by Ministry of Ayush since 2021? Now, who is the Minister of Ayush? It's Mr. Sarbanand Sonowal, right? So this scheme is actually ये बहुत पुरानी scheme नहीं है. It was launched last year in 2021, but again it is in news because of parliamentary reply. So let's talk about this scheme. Remember, the objective of this scheme is to enhance India's manufacturing capabilities and export capabilities in the area of traditional medicine. ताकि जो हमारे traditional medicine का manufacturing capability है वो enhance हो सके और उसमें हम ज्यादा से ज्यादा export कर सके. That is the basic objective of this scheme, right? And also to strengthen regulatory frameworks at center and state level for effective quality control of these traditional medicines. All right. So these are the objective of this scheme. Remember, it was launched last year in 2021. Actually, you can also say it was launched in financial year 2022, right? For a period of implementation up to financial year 2026, with a total outlay of 122 crores. With a total outlay of how much? 122 crores. All right. So that's it. इतना ही पढ़ना है, इससे ज्यादा पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं है. And therefore option A, rupees 122 crores is the correct answer, because in the question the total outlay has been asked. All right. Moving ahead to question number 4. Which oil company has signed an MOU with National Tiger Conservation Authority for supporting the authority for transcontinental relocation of cheetah? This is nothing but Project Cheetah. This is Project Cheetah. I hope you all know about this Project Cheetah, under which some cheetahs are, kuch cheetah ko laya ja raha hai from Namibia. From Namibia to Puno National Park, which is of course in Madhya Pradesh. Right, so this is actually the transcontinental relocation of cheetah from Africa. Namibia is a country from Africa to Asia, right? So that is why it is called as transcontinental relocation. It is being done from Namibia to Puno National Park, which is in Madhya Pradesh, right? So that is Project Cheetah. And an oil company has signed an MOU with National Tiger Conservation Authority, which is the nodal agency for this Project Cheetah, right? And this oil company will support NTCA in implementation of this Project Cheetah. All right. So I hope the Project Cheetah ka basic thing is clear now. You don't have to go into the details of Project Cheetah. That is not required for RBI and NABARD as well. Right. So agar hum baat kare, so the company is Indian Oil Corporation Limited, IOCL. IOCL is the company which has signed MOU with NTCA for effective implementation of Project Cheetah. Now, you must be wondering why an oil company will sign an MOU for Project Cheetah. So I hope you all know this. There is a concept which is known as corporate social responsibility. So as a part of their corporate social responsibility, IOCL will support Project Cheetah. All right. I hope this is clear, that why IOCL has signed this MOU as part of their CSIR. Right. So IOCL will contribute rupees 50.22 crores in 4 years for various components of this project, like habitat management and cheetah introduction, staff training, etc. And it is the first corporate which has signed such MOU to support Project Cheetah, which is being implemented by National Tiger Conservation Authority. All right. So therefore, the correct answer is IOCL option B, which is headed by Mr. Shrikant Madhav Vaidya. Shrikant Madhav Vaidya is the chairperson of IOCL. Moving ahead to question number 5. Which of the following states or UTs is the best performer in Nasha Mukt Bharat Abhiyan of Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment? Very, very important question. And this ministry is headed by Mr. Dr. Virendra Kumar. Right? So let's talk about it. Why it is in news? Nasha Mukt Bharat Abhiyan kyun news mein hai? Because there was a conference that was organized. Right? A national conference on drug trafficking and national security was held at Chandigarh under the chairpersonship of Union Home Minister Amit Shah, who is also of course the Minister of Cooperation. And as the name suggests, this conference was organized to discuss the initiatives being taken by the governments to stop the drug abuse and how we can, effectively improve that. Right? So during the event, two modules of Nav Chetana for class 6 to 8 and class 9 to 10th were launched. Right? For classes 6 to 8 and 9 to 10 were launched. Two modules of Nav Chetana. Now you must be wondering, Nav Chetana kya hai? नव चेतना स्टैंड फॉर न्यू कॉन्शियस ऑन लाइफ स्किल्स एंड ड्रग एजुकेशन फॉर स्कूल चिल्ड्रन एंड इट इज अ टीचर ट्रेनिंग मॉड्यूल. नव चेतना इज अ टीचर ट्रेनिंग मॉड्यूल टू क्रिएट अवेयरनेस अमंग स्टूडेंट्स रिगार्डिंग ड्रग अब्यूज. ठीक है, ड्रग के जो हार्मफुल इफेक्ट्स है उनके बारे में अवेयरनेस जनरेट करता है दिस नव चेतना एंड इट इज अ टीचर ट्रेनिंग मॉड्यूल बेसिकली. सो इट इज अ टीचर ट्रेनिंग मॉड्यूल टू इंक्रीज अवेयरनेस इन एजुकेशन ऑन लाइफ स्किल्स एंड ड्रग्स अमंग स्टूडेंट्स इन स्कूल्स इन इंडिया. ऑलराइट, दैट इज नव चेतना. एंड ड्यूरिंग द इवेंट द बेस्ट परफॉर्मिंग स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज एंड डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स वर अवॉर्डेड इन द नशा मुक्त भारत अभियान. सो अमंग ऑल द स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज मध्य प्रदेश इज द बेस्ट परफॉर्मर फॉलोड बाय जम्मू एंड कश्मीर एंड गुजरात. And among the districts, these are the top three districts, which are Dadiya, Thobal and Chandigarh. Alright. So do remember the name of the districts as well. These can also be asked in your exam. And now let's come back to the question. But here the question is regarding the state or UT. So that's Madhya Pradesh. Option E, which is the best performer in Nasha Mukt Bharat Abhiyan of Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. Alright. Moving ahead to question number 6. Consider the following statements with respect to crop diversification program being implemented by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare and you have to identify the incorrect statement. All right. So crop diversification program, it is being implemented by this ministry under Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana. It is a sub scheme under Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana and as the name suggests, it is a crop diversification program, which means the farmers are motivated to diversify their crops, right? So, which crops? मतलब हम यहाँ पे कौन से crops को diversify करने की बात कर रहे हैं? So, to encourage tobacco growing farmers to shift to alternative crops or cropping system in 10 states across India, जहाँ पे tobacco सबसे ज़्यादा उगाया जाता है, right? So, basically, the government wants to encourage these tobacco growing farmers to diversify their crops to shift to different other crops, right? And it was launched in financial year 2016 and till now, total 111889 acres of land has been shifted from tobacco farming to other crops, right? And this scheme is being implemented in these 10 states where tobacco is grown in large amount. These are Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Gujarat, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Odisha, Tamil Nadu, Telangana, UP and West Bengal. ठीक है? And yes, you have to remember the name of these states because आजकल कुछ भी पूछ लेते हैं. So do remember the name of these states, okay? And now let's come back to the question. You have to identify incorrect statement. It was launched in 2014-15. No, that was 2015-16 when it was launched, all right? It is being implemented in 15 states. Is that so? No. 10 states. And it is a sub-scheme under Krishonnati Yojana. No, it is a sub-scheme under Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana, RKVY. So all are correct, which means option E will be the correct answer, 1, 2 and 3. Moving ahead to question number 7. Again based on a scheme, which scheme is being implemented by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, which is headed by Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar, right? For construction or renovation of godowns or warehouses in rural areas in these states, right? So let's talk about this scheme. Remember, the object is already mentioned in the question. The objective of this scheme, it is, the name of the scheme is Agriculture Marketing Infrastructure Scheme, right? The name is asked in the question because uske alawa kuch puchne laayak isme hai nahi. The objective is to provide financial assistance for construction of godowns or warehouses in rural areas in the state so that the storage capacity of the farmers in rural areas can be improved, right? So assistance इसमें जो मिलती है that is subsidy at the rate of 25% and 33%. It is the range between 25% and 33.33% on capital cost of the project based on the category of eligible beneficiary. Right? How much subsidy will a beneficiary get that will depend on its category. Right? And these are the various categories like individuals, farmers, group of farmers, FPOs and other stakeholders, which are required such godowns or warehouses for storage capacities, right? And therefore, the correct answer will be what? Option D, Agriculture Marketing Infrastructure Scheme. Option D is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 8. Ministry of MSME, which is headed by Mr. Narayan Tau Rane, right, has developed various portals to create a conducive environment for the promotion and development of MSME. Which of the following portals has been developed for public procurement policy for MSME? So we are going to talk about three portals जिसके बारे में PIB में आया है और ये आपसे directly exam में पूछा जा सकता है. So these three portals are MSME संबंध, समाधान and champions. So संबंध portal is for monitoring the implementation of public procurement policy for MSMEs, right? Samadhan portal is for empowering MSMEs to register their cases related to delayed payments. Just remember the keywords, right? For MSME Sambandh, public procurement, ठीक है? For Samadhan, delayed payments, because ये अगर आपको दिख गया एग्जाम में तो आप आंसर मार्क कर सकते हो. पूरा पूरी लाइन मत याद करो, just remember the keywords. Sambandh is for public procurement, Samadhan is for delayed payments, while champions is for grievance redressal, right? And there is a full form of champions as well. Creation and harmonious application of modern processes for increasing the output and national strength. All right. And the question is regarding a portal which is for public procurement policy for MSME, which means option A, Sambandh, will be the correct answer, because that is the portal which is working for monitoring and implementation of public procurement policy for MSMEs. Okay. Moving ahead. Question number 9. National Education Society for Tribal Students, which in short is NEST, and CBSC in collaboration with Tata Trust, TIS and Mahatma Gandhi International School have launched Experiential Learning for 21st Century program. In how many stages the program will be implemented? So this is not a new program. It is its phase 2. Earlier its phase 1 was launched in the year 2021, last year. I think in the month of November, I believe. Right? So let's talk about it. So as already mentioned in the question, it has been launched by National Education Society for Tribal Students and CBSC in collaboration with Tata Trust, Tata Institute of Social Sciences and Mahatma Gandhi International School. Now the objective, basically it is a professional development training program for teachers in Eklavya Model Residential School. Eklavya Model Residential Schools, it is a scheme basically under which special school for tribal students are being constructed by the Ministry of Tribal Affairs, right? So यहाँ के जो teachers हैं, उनकी professional development training की जाएगी under this program, and the name is what? Experiential Learning for 21st Century. Okay. Now its phase 1 was launched last year in 2021 for 350 teachers, 350 teachers from CBSC and ERMS, EMRS. The phase 1 was launched for schools which are located in 6 states. मतलब 6 states के लिए launch हुआ था. These are Maharashtra, Chhattisgarh, मध्य प्रदेश, कर्नाटका, त्रिपुरा एंड अरुणाचल प्रदेश. ओके, बट नाउ द सेकंड फेज व्हिच हैज बीन रिसेंटली लॉन्च, इट हैज बीन लॉन्च फॉर 300 टीचर्स फ्रॉम दी स्कूल्स. ठीक है, फ्रॉम अदर स्कूल्स एज वेल. 300 टीचर्स के को ट्रेनिंग दी जाएगी फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ 8 वीक. ठीक है, 8 हफ्तों का ये ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम होगा. एंड सम न्यू स्टेट्स हैव बीन एडेड टू दीज 6 स्टेट्स व्हिच आर गुजरात, हिमाचल प्रदेश, तेलंगाना एंड उत्तराखंड. सो इन टोटल दिस program is now being implemented in 10 states. Total kitne honge? 10 states honge. Pehle kitne the? 6. Alright. So that is it. And now let's come back to the question. So in how many states it will be implemented? So it will be implemented in 10 states, because earlier there were 6 states where the phase 1 was implemented. And now in phase 2, 4 new states have been added. So in total there are 10 states. Okay. Moving ahead to question number 10. Which of the following organizations is implementing adolescence education program to make the learners aware of the concerns of adolescence? Now in this particular program there is no need to go into the details, because hame koi detail provided nahi ki gayi hai PIB mein. Just remember this organization is NCRD. Option C is the correct answer. And detail nahi bhi provide ki gayi hai tab bhi isme zarurat nahi hai jaane ki, because there are lot of schemes for which the details are not provided. But yes, hum usko discuss karte hain yahan. ठीक है, क्योंकि वो तो एक नाम लिख के चल देते हैं पीआईबी में, बट हमें उसको निकालना पड़ता है उसकी डिटेल. बट फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रोग्राम नो नीड ऑफ डिटेल्स. एनसीईआरटी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. एज पर कंज्यूमर प्रोटेक्शन एक्ट 2019, अ कंज्यूमर कैन फाइल कंज्यूमर कंप्लेंट इन कंज्यूमर कमीशन ऑफ अप्रोप्रिएट ज्यूरिसडिक्शन ऑफलाइन और ऑनलाइन यूजिंग दिस पोर्टल व्हिच इज नोन एज ई दाखिल. राइट, रिमेंबर द नेम ऑफ पोर्टल, ई दाखिल. According to this act, a district consumer dispute redressal commission has jurisdiction to entertain complaints where the value of the goods or services paid as consideration does not exceed how much, right? कितना कितने तक के payment के disputes को district consumer dispute redressal commission entertain कर सकता है. Basically the question is this. So for district level consumer dispute redressal commission, the maximum amount for which it can entertain the cases, it is rupees 50 lakhs, right? It is rupees 50 lakhs. While if I talk about the state level dispute grievance redressal commission, so it is more than 50 lakh, more than 50 lakhs and up to rupees 2 crores and up to 2 crores, right? And if I talk about national level mechanism, so more than 2 crores, right? More than 2 crores. But this question is regarding district level consumer dispute redressal commission. Therefore, the correct answer is option A, 50 lakh. Moving ahead to question number 12. Which section of Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act gives central government the power to add new works in the permissible list of works under Schedule 1 of the Act? See, there is a list of works which can be assigned to the workers under MNREGA, right? But more works can be added to that permissible list, and that power lies with the central government. So the question is, under which section this power, the central government has this power? So this is section 29 of MG NREGA Act. Okay, option C is the correct answer. Udyam portal was launched by Ministry of MSME for document-less registration of MSME. When was the portal launched? Very straightforward question. ठीक है, बहुत ही सीधा साधा question है. It was launched in 2020. Option C is the correct answer. आगे बढ़ते question number 14 पे. Name the web portal of Government of India which provides the interface for blood banks, data management and integration, and it is being managed by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, headed by Mansukh Mandavia. So this portal is for blood banks data management, right? And the name of this portal is e-Raktkosh. Option D is the correct answer. E-Raktkosh. आगे बढ़ जाते. How many भारतीय जनौषधि केंद्रास have been opened under PM भारतीय जनौषधि परियोजना till 30th June 2022 as per a reply submitted by the Ministry of Chemical and Fertilizers in the Parliament. So till 30th June 2022, 8742 Janaushadi Kendras have been established across the countries, and the target is to establish total 10,000 such Kendras. Okay, so we are about to reach the target. And the last question for today, as per National Register of Large Dams 2019 compiled by Central Water Commission, how many dams, how many completed and operational large dams does India have? कितने टोटल हमारे पास कंप्लीटेड और ऑपरेशनल लार्ज डैम्स है? आई थिंक इट इज एन इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन, ये पूछा जा सकता है. जनरली इस तरीके की चीजें न्यूज में नहीं होती हैं, बट दिस टाइम इन्होंने बताया है. एंड दिस नंबर इज 5334. ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर. ऑलराइट, एंड दैट्स इट फॉर टुडे सेशन. आई होप ऑल द क्वेश्चंस एंड देयर एक्सप्लेनेशंस आर क्लियर. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स यू कैन आस्क मी इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. एंड नाउ जो हमारे जो क्लासेस की टाइमिंग है वो वही जैसे पहले थी वैसी हो जाएगी. अभी सेशन डेली हुआ था, बट नाउ द सेशन विल बी कंडक्टेड एज यूजुअली ऑन मंडे, वेडनेसडे एंड फ्राइडे एट 8 AM ओनली ऑन anujjindal.in. ऑलराइट, सो थैंक यू सो मच. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.